Here we are with Tim Ferriss, who just had his last keynote at ETEC, and it was a great honor, I'm sure. Tim is the author of the book, The 4-Hour Workweek, which really should have been called, what, The Drug Dealer's Guide to Fame and Fortune?
That's close. That might have been even better. Drug Dealing for Fun and Profit.
Okay, very good. So I really loved your keynote. It was inspirational and provocative and fun.
Thank you.
So you think people will learn from it and will change? Did you have any feedback of how your message is being actually implemented?
I do. What I like about what has been very surprising and gratifying for me is that the design of the book has translated into people taking small steps through testing. So what I mean by that is some people look at what I do and they assume that I imply they need to use their time the same way. So not checking email for 2 weeks or going to Buenos Aires to tango, and that's not the suggestion at all. It's that they test small concepts, whether that's mini retirement, test assumptions about, let's say, work life, the deferred life plan, as I call it, so postponing what you want to do for some indefinite point in the future. Test that with very small, low risk steps, whether that's practicing small periods of inaccessibility, and picking and choosing. So the book doesn't even need to be read in order. It's more like 16 separate articles. And so for people with families, some will apply, some won't. But there's been a lot of practical feedback. And the strangest thing for me, I think, is that companies have also embraced it. So spoken at Google, to Google management, PayPal, Nielsen, and I think the misinterpretation with the title is that it's about just doing less. And it's actually, it's more about focusing on the critical few instead of the trivial many and increasing productivity. And when you look at the economy in the U.S. and other places, it's slowing down. Each person is required to do more and more. It's very important that they have a time management person that can scale. So it's been very, very redeeming.
I have been talking recently about a new metaphor for the digital divide, which I think is dangerously wrong. Even more so in so-called third world societies, as they strive and get into the Western lifestyle of material consumption, which the planet, we know, cannot sustain for 6 billion people at our current levels. Are you trying and get your message about what digital prosperity could mean in a better organized society to audiences that go beyond those of the U.S.?
Absolutely. That's actually one of my main goals. So I was very focused on making it affordable for foreign publishers to buy the rights to the book for that reason. So the book's actually been sold into, I think, 29 languages, and I want to expand that because I think that the path of consumption for the sake of consumption and the acquisitive nature of modernization is it's number one, very damaging and unsustainable, like you said, but it's also not necessary if we value other currencies like time and mobility. And so when I look at something like web commuting or the ability to work anywhere as long as your work is a measurable product, it's not just so that the end user, you or me, can have a personal perk. There's also a very significant environmental benefit to that. Less driving, fewer cars, etc. And so it's been extremely important for me, especially at an emerging technologies conference. It's always the latest, the greatest, the fastest. And some people ask me, what are these new technologies that have enabled us to, let's say, personal outsource? And the tools actually aren't new to us, let's say, in the U.S. or probably in many places in Italy. But it's some of those dull-edge technologies are only now becoming available in parts of India, Croatia, and that's what's enabling this trade of value. So it's very important. I mean, it's a very key issue.
Thank you very much. It has been fun, and good luck with your book and your new engagements and new projects.
Oh, my pleasure. Thank you very much.
Great stuff.